The SolarWinds MIB database comes with a collection of MIBs from different vendors. So what if the OIDs you're searching for on your device are not in the SolarWinds MIB database? That means it will not be available for management and monitoring in the hybrid cloud observability. To resolve that, try to update your hybrid cloud observability with a new and updated SolarWinds MIB database. Every new release of hybrid cloud observability comes with an updated MIB database. It is updated every few weeks and can be downloaded from the customer portal or installed directly through the web console if your hybrid cloud observability server is internet enabled. You can update between releases, but if you are unable to upgrade to a new release but need a MIB database update, you can do that also. There are two ways on how to update the SolarWinds MIB database. First, you can download the MIBs database directly from the Orion web console. Just log into the web console, click settings, and then all settings. That should bring you to this page. Just look for the details section and click on MIBs management. The MIBs management page informs you about your installed MIBs database and about the latest version. If an updated version of the MIBs database is available, you can click download. This downloads the latest version of the MIBs database as a MIBs.msi file. After the download completes, run the MIBs.msi installer and complete the installation wizard. So accept the terms, click install. The installer will inform you when Orion services need to be restarted and restarts them if necessary. Note that you should run the .msi file on all deployed polling engine, on the main polling engine server, HA backup server, and any additional polling engines. If your hybrid cloud observability server does not have internet access, you will need to go to a computer that does. Then go to the customer portal and download the MIBs file. You can then take that into your environment and update the MIB manually. Full directions on this process are in the knowledge base article in the Success Center. So as you can see, you can download that as an MSI file for the earlier versions, starting from 2020.2 and later. Or for earlier versions, you can download that as a zip file. So what if you have a unique device? How do you add its MIBs to the SolarWinds MIB database? This is a case where there are still no OIDs found in the SolarWinds MIB database. Also, even after the update of the MIB database with the latest releases. So again, how do you add its MIBs to the SolarWinds MIB database? So here's an easy process for you. First is to open a support ticket. Make sure to provide the information about the make and model of your device. And finally, attach your device's MIB file to the ticket. And within a few weeks, you should get an update to the ticket that the MIB database has been updated to include your device's MIBs. You can now go to the customer portal, download the MIB file, and update as we've seen in the previous video. But how do I get the device's MIB file? Good question. An SNMP walk of the device in question will provide the MIB file you need. We have seen in the previous video a screenshot of a MIB file. Now let's try to obtain one. Now we already have one output here, an example of an SNMP walk or a MIB walk. And this shows you the same screenshot as we've seen before. SolarWinds supplies a MIB walk utility, and you can find this in this location. You can also install standalone database if you do not have an RDP to the Hybrid Cloud Observability server by just going to the download section of SolarWinds.com. So let's open the SNMP walk utility. You should supply the correct SNMP information that is configured on the device. For example, the IP address. So let me put the IP address of one of our lab devices. Make sure you put the correct port and the SNMP version. In this case, we are using version 2C. The scan will start at the root of the hierarchy in our example, but you can choose to put the specific OID for a specific metric. Put the correct SNMP community string, then you can save or choose to save the output as a zip file and then click scan. So we're going to do that. And choose the location to save the file. I'm just going to put that on desktop. Now our scan is complete and it found 3 million OIDs. And here is our output for that single device. Once you download and update the database, what does it do? The OIDs you will need will be available to pull. The textual names and information about the OID and that statistic are all mapped in the MIB file, so the update makes that information available. This also allows the hybrid cloud observability to pull and trap SNMP messages from that device. But what does it not do? It will not automatically make the network health and performance monitoring pull for the new OIDs. You have to add them. It will not resolve unsupported OID. Only the manufacturer can resolve that as it's missing on the device. It also will not make the network health and performance monitor automatically discover new devices with the new MIBs. You have to run a discovery or assign pullers.
To access the rest of this training series, log into your customer portal account at customerportal.solarwinds.com.